Hi everybody and welcome to All But Not Obsolete Tech Channel. In this video I'm going to fix a Fortnite setting that usually breaks your game if you are using NVIDIA GeForce GTX graphics card. Furthermore, I will illustrate which video settings offer right now the highest frames per second, and in case you wonder why you need to play Fortnite with the highest possible frames, then after you watch my video of course, you should check out this video, which explains very thoroughly the correlation between low delay, high responsiveness and high frame rate in competitive esports games. You can find the corresponding link in the description. There you can also find the hardware and software specifications of the computer used to run the tests. Now, without any further ado, let's jump to the... If you expected me to say the settings, obviously you are new here, and for better or worse, this channel always precedes a story before the final results and conclusions. In case you don't like stories or you are in a hurry and you want to go straight to the answers, check the timestamps at the description below. Otherwise, stay a while and listen. The reason why I decided to play Fortnite with this 6GB ASUS ROG Strix GTX 1060 was because of the previous disappointing results I had while testing the same game with an AMD Radeon RX 6600 for a video I made in the past, and you can find it here. The fact that the AMD RX 6600 was offering such a stuttery gameplay experience on every rendering mode I tried on was the trigger to get in the comment section this particular reply. Fortnite is a buggy and stutter with all GPU. NVIDIA, AMD, Intel, ARC. Really? I thought immediately. Each and every card? Can this knowledgeable statement be true? So here I was, finding myself testing this time an NVIDIA card, using DirectX 12, 1080p on Epic settings, and as you can clearly see, the well-read statement in the comment section was true. Or at least partial true, as we will discover soon enough together. By my standards, the war situation is unacceptable, and I'm not the only one who experienced this type of issue. How can one of the most famous games in the world have such a problem? And what about the hundreds of thousands of people that play this game uncomplainingly on a daily basis? Do all these people really turn a blind eye to something so obvious, or perhaps thereby hangs a tale yet be told? My mind was ready to embrace every possibility. So I began the tinkering, changing some options here, switching some settings there, and after some considerable long time, Eureka! I had found the cause of the problem. Normally, the effect settings is responsible to add details to objects and raise the graphics fidelity. In our CATS 22 situation, it is also responsible for the terrible stutters. Every time I turn the effects higher than low quality, it will break the game and will generate constant spikes on frame time graph, as well as sudden dips in GPU utilization. With that knowledge, I could calm my mind and bypass the issue just by changing the effects to low. Obviously, this was a temporary fix. So, here I'm going to offer you a more permanent solution to the problem. From your desktop, go to Windows search bar and type Exploit Protection and open it. Click on Program Settings tab and then to the plus sign of Add Programs to Customize. Select the Choose Exact File Path option. From there, find the Fortnite executable file. For example, if your game is installed on Drive C, it will be something like the path you are watching right now on your screen. After you've done this, a new window will pop up. Scroll down to Control Flow Guard. Place a checkmark in Override System Settings and turn this option off. Now, hit Apply and restart the system. From now on, you can use DirectX 12 combined with high effects. I advise you to avoid the epic effects because they still give crappy results. Said and done all that, I believe, now you are ready to know that even if the problem is fixed, it doesn't matter at all. Because there are two better rendering modes that offer a way higher FPS with super stable gameplay. So, the first option implements the rendering mode of DirectX 11 that offers high FPS combined with decent graphics quality and great stability. And the corresponding settings are full screen at 1080 resolution and unlimited frame rate, approximate anti-aliasing, 100% 3D resolution, medium view distance, shadows off, keep the textures low and do not download or enable the high resolution textures. Remember, our priority is high FPS. Choose low effects and low post-processing. Disable all the advanced graphics settings beyond the NVIDIA Reflex low latency that should be kept in on plus boost. With these settings, my ASUS ROG Strix GTX 1060 Gaming was able to offer an absolute smoothly gameplay if you don't count the few micro stutters at the beginning, providing even under the most adverse conditions 160 average FPS and 105 in 1% low. The second setup is all about performance, with the most bearable graphics quality, thus I chose performance mode. Here, select full screen at 1080 resolution and unlimited frame rate, 3D resolution at 100%, epic view distance. Again, keep the textures low and do not download or enable the high resolution textures. Go for low meshes for the highest possible frame or turn it to high for slightly detailed graphics but with 5% low performance. It's entirely up to you. Me personally, I couldn't find any obvious difference in image quality between those two, so I decided to stick with the low meshes. Finally, disable all the advanced graphics settings. With this setup, the GTX 1060 could easily reach the 450 frames per second, producing 211 and 127 FPS on average and 1% low respectively. Last but not least, there are some more options for you to click on if you are satisfied with the video content, and these are the options to leave your like and subscribe to our channel if you haven't done so already. There is also the extra chore to press the notification bell if you don't want to miss our upcoming videos, similar to those that appear on your screen right now. Regardless, thanks for watching, and see you on the next one.